Hey there. In today's video, I'm going to go over my top 5 tips on how to stay organized using Serato DJ Pro. Serato DJ Pro is an amazing DJ software where you can really do a lot with your musical library, but it can get a little confusing on how to stay organized. So that's why I'm sharing these top 5 tips with you today. If you stick around to the end of this video, I'll show you how you could download my free music resource guide where I give you my top 5 websites with resources and music where I download all of my music from. And I'll give you 10 tracks that I think would be great to start mixing with today in the correct order. I'm DJ Nicole Otero, professional DJ from NYC. And on this channel, I post a new video every week where I help aspiring and beginner DJs like you get started on their DJ journey. If you like what you see, click subscribe. So let's get started. So tip number 1 is to tell your computer where to download your music. So in this case, I'm using Chrome as my web browser, and I want to tell Chrome where I want my downloads from BPM Supreme to go. So the first thing I'll do is come up to the Chrome menu bar, and I'm going to go to Preferences. And then down here to the left, I'm clicking Advanced and I'm picking Downloads. And then if you can see right here, right now I have already selected that I want the location to go to my desktop. And then I have a folder on my desktop that's already created called BPM Music. Now, if I wanted to change that, I would just hit Change and then tell it where I wanted it to go. Maybe I had a different folder or... So that's how you would just select. So right now I have a desktop and I want it to go to BPM Music and I press select. And then this you want to keep off. Ask where to save each file before downloading because you already know where it's going now, right? But let's say you started to download other things like PDFs or whatever and you just want that to go to your downloads folder. So then you would change this. So that's the first thing you want to do. So now I'm going to go to BPM Supreme, which is a record pool that you can become a member with that has a lot of awesome music. It has a wide variety with different mixes. So let's say I wanted to download Break My Heart by Dua Lipa. So I'm going to come here and I'm just going to pick the clean one. And now you see that it's downloading right on my, that's how it works with Chrome. It comes right down below on your web browser. And I have Serato DJ Pro already opened. So I'm going to now click on this and bring it into all music, just all right here. Okay. And if I look on my desktop into that BPM Supreme folder, you will see Break My Heart, Dua Lipa was also downloaded there. So if I go back into Serato DJ Pro and let's say I want to see where my music is, I go to files here. And I'm going to go to here and then desktop and then BPM Music. So this is where my music is. So for whatever reason, I wanted to make sure that it was in Serato. I could just drag it into all from here as well. That's the first thing. It'll just help you keep you organized and avoid you losing music in Serato. Because sometimes you might see that yellow thing where it's like, the name of the track is there, but it's yellow because Serato no longer knows where to access that file. So keeping yourself organized where you download your music will definitely help with that. Tip number 2 is to create crates. And it's really simple. You just come up here to the left and you hit the plus sign. And then at the bottom, you'll see crate number 1. So if you double click on there, you can name it. So for this, I'm going to name it 90s hip hop. And then if you want it to be like, I have a lot of crates, obviously. So I'm just going to bring it up to the top so that it's easy to access for me. Now I already have a lot of 90s hip hop in my library. So what I'm going to do is go to all, and then I'm going to just do up here. This is your search. And I'm just going to type artists that I know are 90s hip hop artists. I mean, I'm a 90s girl, so that's easy for me. I could do Das. dots effects, right? I'm going to put that and now drag it here. I could do the Notorious EIG. I've got a lot of stuff with. So now I could just actually click the top track, scroll down, press shift on my keyboard, highlight everything that way, and then just drag it here. And I could do a tribe called Quest, right? So boom. And I could just continue doing that. You just do search here, but you have to make sure that you are in your all. That's telling you that you are in your complete library with all your music. And then if you want to see it, you can go like this. Now, let's say you're maybe not as well versed in knowing the decades in music. So what you could do is sift through artist here, click the artist column, and now it's going to go by artists. That's a really easy way. Yeah, Tupac was in the 90s, so I could go Tupac, right? And then press shift, highlight, bring into 90s hip hop. 50 Cent was more like 2000s, I would say, but you know, I wouldn't be upset by that if I put that in my 90s hip hop folder. It just depends how exact you want to get. That's how you would start to organize your music. And you could do that for now, create a crate for 2000 hip hop, right? And again, just, you know, continue to, you know, drag them up, search for everything in your all. And I highly recommend this because it's a good way for you to visually see and learn your artists and the decade that they're coming from. So that's why I definitely think organizing your music in decades is a good idea. It will educate you, especially if you're just starting out, to understand. It'll help you just start to see, like, you know, commonality in the music of that decade. I honestly, like, you know, you saw I created it. Like, I don't have it, honestly, in mind because I've been DJing a really long time. I also grew up in the 90s, so I really know that music, you know, well. You know, for today's music, I definitely sometimes have to make crates for that just because, you know, today's music is not as relevant to me as like older music because I just have an old soul. But I think that's a good way to start is by decades and also genres. So you don't want to put 90s grunge rock if you're, you know, DJing that in the same folder as 90s hip hop, right? Mm-hmm. That's going to be confusing. So that is it for tip number two. Tip number three, I recommend creating smart crates. Here, you'll see that there is a blue square with an S. So if you come here, now you're going to get this window and it's asking you to add a rule. So if I come here and go add rule, I can say added before the date as a rule or before or, you know, after. It depends. Added after a certain date or before a certain date. So let's say I say added before today's date. Right. And I say, I could also add a rule on top of that, added before today, but after, let's say, you know, I want to know what I downloaded in the last month. So I could go 4/18/21. Okay. And now if you come down here, you'll see that I have a crate and everything that I downloaded in the last month is there. Isn't that cool? So now I could name this, you know, I could say before 5/18, you can't do slashes, to after 4/18. Just so I know the music that I downloaded all of that time. So yeah, smart crates are great. And you could do that for however you want to do it. There's no right or wrong way. It's about keeping you organized. So that was tip number three. So yeah, so my fourth tip is creating columns. So you want to make sure you're in your all. I mean, it doesn't really matter to be honest, but I just like to be in the all. And for me, I like to keep it simple. I think being, you know, just having my song, artist, BPM, key, length of song, and comment is enough for me. But if you wanted to change that, if you come here to the right, just over a little bit, you'll see this little arrow. Here is where you can decide, okay, what other labels do I want, right? You could have bitrate, that lets you know the fidelity of the track, if it's a wave or if it's an MP3, right? So it just tells you the bit rate. But the higher the bit rate, the better quality it is, because it'll give you more of a dynamic range. But I really don't care about that when I'm DJing, because I use my ears and to let me know if a mix sounds good or not. You could have it in genre. That could be really helpful, actually, just to let you know, because then you could sort. So now that I have these, right? Like before, I showed you can sort by artist. Well, now if I wanted to sort by genre, that's great. Like, oh my goodness, I didn't realize I had so much alternative in here. I've got blues, I've got, you name it, classical. I do everything now, but disco, electronic, lots of electronic. So here are my genres. Super helpful to decide what columns you would like to use. And again, if you just want to remove it, so genre, I just go like that. Okay. Now, another thing you may want to do, this is my fifth tip, is link your columns when you're sorting through music. So let's say I not only want to know the speed, the BPM, the tempo of the track, but I also want to know what key it's in. So if I click here and then press Command. Okay, so if you click on one and then press Command, you can highlight both of them. Now they're linked. So if you want to sort, now you just have to click on one of them and you'll see not only, you'll click on BPM. So you see how now I have everything that's 71 BPM, but it's also grouping together what key it's in, right? So that's fun. Now I know that not only are these tracks in the same BPM, but they're in the same key, which makes mixing just a more pleasurable experience for the listener if you are mixing tracks that are in key. And, that's something to go way more in depth, which I do in a DJ course that I'm creating. But those are my five tips. I hope that they help you become more organized in your budding DJ career. As promised, if you scroll down to the bottom of this video, I have a link where you can download my music resource guide listing my top five websites and 10 tracks that I think would be great for you to get started DJing with today. I'm DJ Nicole Otero, professional DJ from NYC, and on this channel, I post a video every week to help aspiring and beginner DJs like you get started on their DJ journey. If you like what you see, click subscribe. So I'll see you next week, DJ. Bye.